culture, Holy Nepha, the Patron, welcome the people, holy people of Ireland of Irish ancestry. This is, I believe, our fourth annual Irish Mass and offering in Glaelga. My name is Father Andrew O'Connor. I wasn't here last year down at a mission in Guatemala. But we're grateful for the New York Irish Historical Roundtable and Monsignor Don to host us here again at Old St. Patrick's, this historical place. You can help with the beginning of the Mass if you found in your programs. If you'd like to open up, and we'll read the Meteor. In nominem oper, agus an vic, agus an spirit ne, amen. Gori matirna le. A bribe. Cognition of poppy, and Cleveland foot, and reaching on top of the hill. Padrino yeo, agus dreche, a bribe. The poppy, Megatro, the Swina Augusta Brief, and Neve Augusta Folly, Nima Horfane, Dreamy Mo Horfane, Dreamy Mo Horfane, Aaron Aurashin, Impimage and Neve Wuro, Tiro, Aaron Apple, Augusta Arani, Arisha, and Raisha, Guyan Mohun, and Hirnagia, Guyanagia Mulahumata, Trochera Orin, Amashe, Ambakish, Dun, Agus Vitror, Nahum, Abrea Sir Shin. Amen.
Thank you. Yekman Shatirna, and the Dharma Chatur, Atma Kapana Kwani, Gagama Anima Tirna, Jiva Mamabhutana Shatirna, Rabina Shafali. Frederick, Kekutu Yekman Shatirna, and the Dharma Chatur. The Slugwood of Lahana Tirna lies at Yin, especially Yomi Kirna, Shai Smak Tachani Namshir, Spring to Kutu Kirkir. Frederick,
Beshir, our folly. Arish, the
louder than low. Do re shi. To ye iri sa su sar ne. Agus hui she u shui. Andesh la je. Akshe shui. Nemo jar yo agus kreish kyo de jar. In the nacht art. Agus kroi and cheer and yo in year two of Ryan Lish Kamarti Lane Sonish Skelje somehow in English. But it's interesting from the point of view of why St. Patrick would, and not just because I'm Irish, but would say from my Irish background, why it's important to hear the Irish language in America, our fallen Huelga in America, to learn Irish here. And I want to give you the tale really of two lost languages here in America. The first would be obviously Irish. Most of the Irish immigrants who did come here after the famine were by and large people who spoke English, although they were steeped obviously in the Irish language. Just recently there was a book, and if you're writing a book about Irish things, you release it in March, right? That's a good time to get your Irish public and people to buy it. But one looks like a particularly good book, and it happens to be by James Barrett, published by Penguin Press, called The Irish Way. And what he wants to do is to tell the perspective of how the first large ethnicity, the Irish, coming to America, how they influenced it, influenced life here in America for the immigrants that came afterwards. And there were good things and bad things, and obviously if you're a fan of Martin Scorsese, who was an altar server here, he tells his version in the film on the New York's gangs of New York. And by and large true as well. It was a rough life, and they were involved in all sorts of good and bad things back in the day. But Barrett says that with the subsequent arrival of immigrants, the Irish played a certain role, that the world that the immigrants went into, maybe from Eastern Europe, was a world that was controlled by policemen who were by and large Irish. You had people who worked at the bar or they controlled the tickets, politicians. Irish were, through the English language, able to influence politics very well. Mr. Barrett also comes up with another sort of startling statistic which should open our eyes. And that is that with these immigrant classes were a whole sector of, in particular, Irish-born nuns who helped to care for blacks coming up from the South, educate them, and also from the, up until the 1880s onward, helping people afflicted with poverty, unemployment, illness, alcoholism, helping widows, deserted wives, and orphans. And the author states that though Jane Addams and other Protestant reformers sought to aid the immigrant poor, and they have captured the historian's imagination, he says that by the 1880s, Irish nuns were already caring for 80% of New York City's dependent children. 80% of New York's dependent children, no matter what the race, religion, creed, or color. That's a remarkable statistic in an era when parents commonly died, left, were injured in some way so that they couldn't care for children. And it also says that in the subtext, these Irish nuns carried with them a worldview, were also highly influential in our democratic expansiveness that's part of the United States. And it's certainly an issue that needs to be recalled as the role of women and of the church in helping to focus real freedom's energy, if you will, onto the poor was addressed. So when that to be. The other language that I wanted you to consider is the loss of German. People often don't realize that the most widely spoken language in the United States by Americans up until 1918 was German. Woodrow Wilson was probably the only president that we know that spoke German, or maybe Eisenhower afterwards. But these tale of two languages, we have to say, well, what happened to the German? We know that in Irish history, the language diminished because of the politics and history vis-a-vis England. It seemed like an inevitable march of the Industrial Revolution that the Irish would lose their language and throw in that famine. But why did the Germans lose their language here in the United States? They lost their language primarily through the shame of the two world wars. The Germans were, unlike other immigrants, they were very organized to have their own newspapers. They had their own schools. They had such a widely disseminated system of Turnverein, of little gymnasiums throughout Germany, and they still exist even here in New York. But the loss of German created something that was called Americanization. And both the Irish and the Germans are very important in creating an Americanization of blending peoples into this hodgepodge of America. I think now as we celebrate St. Patrick, we need to also recognize that our identity needs to be healed. That the loss of language also results in suffering. It's not only just a success story that we moved on to another language. It also says there's something about our souls that needs to be healed spiritually. And so, celebrating St. Patrick, who wasn't Irish but went to the Irish Irish people, learned their language, loved their people, is a testimony that it's also, if the Irish were so important within the scope of bringing about healing of immigrant peoples to America, I think today also we need to restore to our language the spiritual foundation that we have a heritage with in St. Patrick. Vermont.
I have a 102-year-old aunt in Iowa who's Irish, and I said that I would offer the Mass for her, Mary, and Mary Carr. And we want to hold your intentions with us at this Mass. So for all of your families, we pray for those who are endeavoring to learn different languages, the languages of the soul, languages of peoples. Pray for this parish of St. Patrick's with its legacy. We pray for a world fraught with so many divisions, in particular in the Middle East. Pray for Ireland, for all the people suffering there in poverty. Pray for the healing of the church there. Shade for all the world, Talon de Grasta, Ton Chirnalon, Ishvanahu Irna, Akasisvanatar of the Brony Isa, Ani Wara, Maharjay, who we are in the Pagan Nish, Aksa Ura Wash. Amen. Please be seated.
We now offer our gifts of bread and wine, simple gifts that become for us in the celebration of the Eucharist, the body and blood of the Lord. We also appreciate the gifts that you make to our cause. Please be generous in your offering.
Amen.
Tarim Chernalev. Togakin Weir Glintanarja. Tashin Poganarja. Tashirna Arja. Given Gwim Gavamish, Buihas Lesha Chernajia. Ishkart Axis Kordu. Adenim Kuya Agis. Kaur. Buihas Agavale Hanshin. Ahir. Axin Gacha Aj. Anahar Nifa. Tre Momach. Mordia Isa Christ. Asin and Vriah. Trina, Hugitu, Gakawila, Asin and Slanahur, Ahur and Lenar and Wiscout, Inaliu, Nehuach, Ashberit Nev, Agas Rubi Yoan, Wagajin Mora, Holyo Shil, Shilahol, Agas, Kanovi Bogom Nifra, Dichnor Shin She. Amar Kalava are in Krosh Keshtachay, Abasha Shreish, Agasan Tesh Ayri, Kun Abaha Liru Aleru. Lavrishin, Ipart Nesan Achel, Agas Leshan Nivila, Mormit Gaglor, Aru Gaglor.
And I see it increased. A frolic in the terrain. we cause that is review that not vain in our shasha in the locker of following the ditch. Here it is, the kohulers are an yitife achille, a court and spirit name, shayeta parte, a court as a weak priest. Tarakul kuna, a year the jian, they wish, and fool the dog. Narti, a kuna, a gridach, and then papa benedict, agus lemonis big, Timothy, agus lech and clear.
Thank you. joy and unity. Joy and day of holding Baki and Dole. His mother there too, before Corey Holmes Siri only. A year now, before the end of the life of the union of the culture of the problem of his Italian ceremony.
Soach, Achora, Hola, Achir, Asil, Deeply apologize to all the Irish speakers who have slaughtered your language up here. I confess.
a great idea.
Oh, she works at a school.
I have an education, and I've been saying forever that.
Thank you.
Irish dance. We teach at the Irish Arts Center, 51st and 11th, at the New York Irish Center in Long Island City. And if anybody is interested in Irish dancing class, just come over and talk to me and I'll give you the information you might need. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you. great day for the Irish, and today we're all Irish. And there's no better place to start this feast day than here, with the Holy Sacrifice of the Mass in our beloved St. Patrick's Cathedral. Cardinal Ian is with us, a beloved mediocre, a boy from the Bronx, and a new cardinal. Cardinal Evan O'Brien, our preacher this morning. Brother bishops and priests and deacons, consecrated women and men religious, esteemed and appreciated civic leaders, our governor, our mayor, our speaker, Commissioner Kelly and Commissioner Cassano, Grand Marshal Comerford, Ambassador Kilkenny, senators, Mayor Koch, so many esteemed public servants, our police, our fire, our rescue workers, our beloved Fighting 69th, men and women in uniform, neighbors, friends, one and all, welcome. Welcome to St. Patrick's Day at the place that's best celebrated, St. Patrick's Cathedral.
Commissioner?